My name is Nicholas Illingsworth. I'm an effects supervisor at WETA FX. Houdini was used for a wide range of tasks on Avatar. Obviously, water was a large component. There was 2,225 water shots. There were sequences like the Tycoon Hunt, along with some of the end battle sequences that were significantly challenging. For the fire, we had the end battle as well, along with the Wall of Fire, which is when the Sea Dragon catches flame and flips over. Some of the challenges that we tackled on the Tycoon Hunt was the scale of the water, so just the amount that we had to simulate with many creatures and many vehicles. We'd automate a bunch of that to some degree, but then once we'd automated it, and that was being able to run individual simulations per creature or per vehicle. Combining those was a massive challenge, as I'm sure a bunch of people out there have done water simulations. You can split it out, but then how do you merge all that data into a single unified surface? The fire sequence, similarly to a lot of the water inputs, we were using standard Houdini nodes generating VDBs, and then you'd input things like your fuel type, your oxygen, and various other simulation parameters. Within the Loki network itself, we'd have some exposed parameters at the top level in SOPs, so then artists could change some controls, and then we would basically just write that out to whatever file format that we wanted at the time. If it was a VDB, that would just go through a standard ROP network. Challenges for the end sequence was just the scale of the amount of work that we had to do. Also making sure that our fire simulations were believable. One of the really hard things in visual effects is to sell believable fire. And as such, we developed a new chemical combustion model that meant that artists had control over things like their fuel type and equivalence ratio. So you could play around with your fuel and oxygen ratios to give different looks. So Loki is a standalone application, but we do run it inside of Houdini. So effectively, we're discretizing data from Houdini straight into Loki just using VDBs. So we're inputting a VDB, we'll do our Loki solve, and then a VDB then comes out of Loki. So then in terms of the visibility to the user, it's as seamless as using any other Houdini solver to us. The advantages of the setup that we've got now based on Loki and Houdini is the procedural aspect to the workflow. We're able to build and design certain templates, whether it's for a creature getting out the water or a whale giving a splash or even a flame. We're able to design these templates, and we've got a proprietary template loader inside of Houdini that we call Kaita that enables leads and seniors and supervisors to author these templates that can then be loaded by any artist. Also, Houdini being the industry standard tool, as we had a rapid onboarding at the end of the project, it meant that artists could hit the ground running. They were already familiar with Houdini. Other than loading our templates and educating them how to use those templates, they're already good to go, which was a huge benefit. So the aspects of proceduralism that help support the creative process, it helps us to be incredibly dynamic with our creative process. We're able to build quite complex networks and templates and then know that this would be scalable. Also, with our review process, Jim, by the end of the film, was very used to seeing Houdini play blasts, sometimes to help get motion approvals through. So if there was a complex water simulation with one of our giant Tycoon, Jim would want to see those together. So being able to present this work very fast and efficiently was very beneficial for us. What would I say to an upcoming Houdini artist that wants to work at WETA? Yeah. It's an amazing experience. I've been at WETA for the last 10 years, and I've really seen the uptake of Houdini over those years, which has been fantastic. Our workflows have evolved. It's incredibly enjoyable to work within the WETA framework with Houdini. The world that we're able to create with Houdini is fantastic.